Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to another awesome YouTube video. This is Tremaine here back again with more value. Now guys, before we kickstart today's video, I just want to mention guys, the comment section is yours. Let me know what topics you would like to get into in the future. Obviously relating to Forex and well, any financial market. As well as your like, save your like until the end of the video after you've watched it, gained as much value as possible, drop a like. If you've gained the value that is intended to be transferred or imparted onto you by this video. Now guys, to kick things off, we're gonna get into basically identifying order flow. So we're gonna first speak about generally what order flow is, and then we're going to go into how to identify order flow, and then also the different concepts that I use to kind of give me an idea, general idea of where order flow is going, and also how I can be able to capitalize or use order flow to actually execute positions within the Forex market. Now guys, to go over, we just have 2 points guys, and don't think that these 2 points are going to be very simple for us to go through. It's actually very extensive. So the first point is basically structure, and the second point is basically order blocks or low bear and high bull candles. So we're going to speak about what order flow is first of all. Now all order flow is just gauging or getting an idea of which direction the orders in the market are being executed. Now remember, there are different market participants. Obviously there's us retail traders, and there's also institutions, hedge funds, all of those people with a whole lot of money, with an endless amount of money essentially. And so what order flow, or what the concept of order flow is kind of identifying where smart money, or where the big money, is basically placing their orders. Where is the big money looking to take the market to? That's all order flow is. Now going into order flow, we'll start off with structure. How do we identify order flow, or find out what order flow is doing based off structure? Guys, we go straight back to the basics, the basic stuff: higher highs, lower lows, lower highs. That basic stuff, guys. So obviously we know the three different characteristics of markets. We have, first of all, ranging markets, where we have obviously equal lows and equal highs being generated in the market. This is what we would call a range or consolidation. There's a lot of words for all of these concepts and stuff, but I just want us to understand this whole thing as the market having found a fair value area, or having found a price where both buyers and sellers are willing to transact, or are both willing to buy and sell. That's why consolidations happen, because there are both buyers and sellers active within the markets at a specific price point, or within a specific price point. Now that's the first, obviously the first structure that we have. Then the next structure that we do have is obviously trending markets, which is an uptrend or a downtrend. Obviously an uptrend would be categorized by us having a market creating, or let's just try and use a different marker because this marker is not working. We'll just try, so obviously uptrending markets are categorized by a market that is essentially creating higher highs and higher lows. So every low is higher than the previous low, and you'll see that every high is higher than the previous high. And guys, I know this is very basic stuff that we're going back into, but this is important for us to lay the foundation, because when we get onto order blocks and high bull and low bear candlesticks, we will see how the trend, or how the structure, basically gives us the information. And we just use the order blocks and the high bull, low bear to kind of refine what we're looking at. So uptrending markets, obviously we said higher highs and higher lows all the way up. Downtrending market would be the exact inverse of this. So after we see something like that, then we basically see lower lows, or LL, and lower highs. That is basically our characteristic of a downtrending market. Now markets are either doing one of two things. Markets are either trending, or markets are consolidating, or they are in these corrective phases. Now going into order blocks. Now I'm gonna explain to you guys exactly what an order block is, and the reason why I have order blocks slash high bull and low bear is because order blocks are essentially high bowl candlesticks and low bay candlesticks, just depending on what you want to understand or which term you want to use. Remember, there's thousands and thousands of terms to use for these different things. But what I want us to do by going through these videos is for us to understand the general idea of what is happening. Now, let's just erase all of this stuff here. We will redraw it and we will go back into all of this stuff. But let's get on to an order block and what is an order block. Now, generally what an order block is a candlestick that was used to add orders in. Now, what do we mean by add orders in? Let's just take a hypothetical example and say we have an uptrend. Now, we know an uptrend, obviously, we just spoke about it, higher highs, higher lows. Now, we obviously will get a retest of these previous resistance areas. Obviously, market has broken through and we're now expecting these resistance areas to turn into support. Now, what do a lot of people look for at support? Maybe people look for pin bars, bullish engulfing candlesticks, all that kind of stuff. All an order block is we'll use the red candle, the red marker to denote a red candlestick, and I'll just leave bullish candlesticks open. So all an order block is this last red candlestick before the violation of these previous highs here. So obviously, maybe if we have sort of like a bullish engulfing candlestick, this last red candlestick to the downside after prices have closed above these previous resistance areas will be considered to be an order block. Why is it an order block? Because, guys, I'm gonna introduce something to you guys I know a lot of smart money traders know and use these types of interpretations, but a lot of retail traders don't really know these kind of things. Now, this is a concept that I'm gonna introduce to you guys. Markets need to sell in order to buy, and markets need to buy in order to sell. Now, what's happening within this order block? Remember this last red candle before prices violated previous higher structure to the upside. We said that this last red candle is going to be considered to be an order block. Why is it an order block? Because within this last candle to the downside, institutions were adding their buy positions. So this last move to the downside was a move to trap traders on the wrong side of the market so that they can execute their buy orders. That's why this is an order block. Now, what generally happens with order blocks is that price normally comes into the order block and then rejects further. Even if we have, for example, an example with a double top structure, we'll have a double top. Obviously, there'll be this last bear candle over here, or this last bullish candle before we see a nice red candle to the downside, and this will obviously be our order block. And then the general structure of a double top is that the second peak must touch the close of the first peak, but not close above the high of the first peak. And now all a double top is retesting the supply within that last order block. Now, going into what a high bull and a low bear is, remember we said this last red candlestick. Let's think about what's happening here. The reason why we're calling this a low bear is because this is the last area where we see sellers coming into the market. Now, obviously, we know that there are sellers that have jumped into the market here. So when prices do come back into this order block, the market makers don't want to make anyone leave the markets with money, unfortunately. Now, all of these sellers, obviously, if prices go up, then they're in a negative. When prices come back down, more often than not, prices will never go below these lower structures here. And the reason being is because market makers understand that there were sellers involved in this move to the downside, and they obviously don't want to give them or don't want to put those sellers into profits. Now, that is obviously an example of a low bear. Now, what a high bull candlestick would be if the market is trending to the upside and we see a nice bullish candlestick followed by a nice bearish candlestick, obviously here on our right-hand side. once we see this bearish candlestick and obviously prices going down and then violating lower structure, this last bullish candlestick will be considered a high bear candlestick. And obviously if we're talking about order blocks, this would also be considered a order block. And if prices were to actually pull up to the upside, prices more often than not will just tap into this order block and then push away from that order block and not really go above this order block. Because if prices do go above this order block, what's going to happen? All of the people that were involved in this buy just before prices went down, they are now able to exit the market with profit. And obviously, markets are for business. People want to make money. The people with the most money make the most money. And so they want to get all of us retail traders out of the market. So they really give us an opportunity to exit with some profit. Now guys, I don't want to talk about manipulations too much because there are going to be other videos where we go over manipulations and how these low bear and high bull candlesticks are manipulated to try and get the last retail traders out of the market before the move actually happens. But just to set a foundation on order flow, we want to be trading in the direction of order flow. Now, we went over structure, how to identify order flow. Obviously, structure will give us an idea of where buyers or where sellers are taking the market to. If we see that uptrend, then obviously there are more buyers involved in the market, and where should we be looking to trade? If there's an uptrend, we should be looking to trade off these low bear candlesticks or these bullish order blocks. We should be waiting for price to tap back into these areas before we actually look for our smaller time frame reversals for the continuation of the order flow. Remember, if orders are flowing to the upside, then market will generally move to the upside. And if orders are flowing to the downside, then the market will generally move to the downside. Now, obviously the inverse, if we were in a downtrend, what would we be waiting for? We would be waiting for prices to retest these high bull candlesticks or these bearish order blocks. Now, to quickly identify an order block, this is a kind of life hack order block identification thing that I mentioned or that I went through with some of the members. So basically, if you see a bullish engulfing candlestick, we're familiar with bullish engulfing candlesticks. If we have, for example, a red candle to the downside over there, and then we have this nice bull candlestick that closes above the high of this previous candlestick, that's obviously a bullish engulfing candlestick. Now we can assume that at support and at resistance, every bullish engulfing candlestick has a bullish order block. This last red candle that the bull candle engulfed would be considered the order block, and all we're doing is waiting for prices to tap back into the order block or into the low bear candlestick before the continuation to the upside. Now, I've spoken a hell of a lot, guys. We're gonna get into some charts so that we can refine these ideas and so that you can see how we actually use these ideas to profit in the Forex market. Now, see you guys in the charts.